In this video, we're continuing on with the Center and Spread of Data worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up where we left off, in this video, I'm going to complete numbers 3 and 4. So remember, we're going to be finding the mode, so let's start with that. Now the mode is the number that occurs the most. So going through our data, we can see that 50 occurs twice. So far, that's the greatest frequency, and no other number occurs twice. So our mode is 50. The next part of data we're supposed to figure out is the median. Now lucky for us, our data is already ordered. So we're going to cross out the lowest, cross out the highest number, going back and forth, crossing out the next lowest, and then the next highest, and so on until we reach that middle number. So 34 and 65, 39 and 60, 40, 58, 43, 56, 44, 55, 47, 54, 50, 53, and you can see we have two numbers left, that's 50 and 52, so we're going to need to find the number that's between those, which will be a positive 51. But if you need to see that worked out, we're going to add 50 to 52, and then divide that by 2 to find that number in the middle. And 50 plus 52 divided by 2 is indeed equal to 51. So our median is 51. Now we're going to find our mean. And our mean is the average of the data. So we're going to add each of these numbers together and then divide by the amount of data we have. So we'll add 34 to 39 to 40 to 43 and so on. And then divide that sum by the number of data points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So that sum will get divided by 16. So adding those up on my calculator equals 800. And when I divide 800 by 16, I will get 50 as the mean. Now the next attribute of this data we're finding out is quartile 1, which is the median of the lower half. And that means that 50 will be included in that lower half of the data. So between 34 and 50, we're finding that median. So cross out the lowest, highest, next highest, and so forth of that lower half, and will be between 43 and 44. So 43 plus 44 divided by 2, finding that middle value between those two, we will get 43.5. And now for quartile 3, going through the same steps, but for the upper half of the data, we'll cross out 52, cross out 65, back and forth and so on till we get to 55 and 56. So we'll take 55, add it to 56, and then divide it by 2. Essentially finding that middle point, which halfway in between 55 and 56 is going to be 55.5. Now we'll find that interquartile range, the IQR. And the IQR is Q3 minus Q1. So quartile 3, the upper quartile, minus quartile 1, the lower quartile. So 55.5 minus 43.5 is going to equal 12. And then lastly, we need to find the standard deviation, which is represented by the Greek letter sigma. Now, standard deviation is the square root of 1 over n, which is 1 over the count, so how many data points there were, which we got to be 16, times the sum of our data points, so x sub I, that value. So either 34, 39, 40, and so on, we're going to be subtracting the mean, which is represented by the letter mu, squared. So we're going to take 34, subtract our mean of 50, and then square that value, and then add it to 39 minus 50 squared, and then add that to 40 minus 50 squared, and so on, all the way up until 65 minus 50 squared. And once those are summed together, we'll divide it by our count, the total number of data points within our tables, which is 16. Now, thankfully, there's calculators online, so we don't have to work out this math by hand. And one of the calculators I like using is the Math is Fun calculator, which I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this calculator. What I like about this is that it shows you almost step by step. It breaks it up to where it shows you the values that you would get as you work through the problem. So typing in our data set, we'll type in 34, 39, 40, and so on. So typing in all those, you can see our count is 16, our sum of the numbers was 800, and our mean was indeed 50. So that's just a good way to double check to make sure you entered your data correctly. And now you can see that the differences, so if we were to take 34 and subtract 50, that would give us negative 16, and then that number squared was 256, and it shows you each of the differences squared for each data value, and then it sums those, which would be 1,050, and then divides it by our count, so how many numbers there were, which was 16, and that is technically the variance, but we don't want the variance, we want the standard deviation. So then taking the square root of that 65.625, we get 8.100, which rounds to 8.1. So our standard deviation for number 3 is 8.1. Now let's move on to number 4. And number 4, we're starting with the mode. Now 4 occurs twice, and 7 occurs 3 times, so 7 is more than that. However, the number that occurs the most is 6. 6 occurs 4 times, so 6 is our mode. Next, we'll find our median, which is the number in the middle, and our data is ordered from least to greatest. So crossing out Colorado, then Rhode Island, Louisiana, New Jersey, Wyoming, Indiana, back and forth. Until we get to Idaho of 6. So 6 is our median. Now we'll find our mean, which is the average. So we're going to add each of these numbers up and then divide by the amount of numbers we added. So adding 2.9 to 4 to 4 to 4.5 to 5 to 5.125 to 5.5 to 6 to 6, 6 again, and then that fourth 6 plus 6.15 plus 6.25 plus 6.5 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7. Summing those up and then dividing by the count, which there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 data points within our set. So adding all those together, we'll get 94.925, and then dividing that by 17, we'll get 5.583, which rounds to 5.58. So that's equal to 5.58. Now we'll find quartile 1 and quartile 3. So looking at our lower half of the data, we'll cross out 2.9, 6, 4, 5.5, 4, 5.125, and then we'll be between 4.5 and 5. So we'll add 4.5 to 5 and then divide that by 2, which will give us 4.75. Now for quartile 3, we'll be between 6.25 and 6.5. So we'll add 6.25 to 6.5 and then divide that by 2. We'll get 6.375. Now, the next step is our IQR, which is the interquartile range, which is Q3 minus Q1. So that's going to be 6.375 minus 4.75, which equals 1.625. And then lastly is our standard deviation. And remember, standard deviation is the sum of each of our data points subtracted by the mean squared, and then we're dividing that by the count. And for this, I'll use an online calculator, just so you can see. So let's start by typing in our data points. So we have 2.9. And a good way to double check to make sure you have your data typed in correctly is that the count is indeed 17, our sum giving us that mean of 5.58. And you can see the differences. So taking 2.9 and subtracting the mean of 5.58, and then squaring that will give us that 7.202. So if we do that to each of our data values and then sum them together, that will be 22.266, which rounds to 27. And then if we were to divide that by the count, that would give us our variance of 1.301, which rounds to 1.31. And then taking the square root of that, we'll be at 1.144, which rounds in number 4 to 1.14. So our standard deviation in number 4 is 1.14. And with that, we finish up this video. Join me in the next video where I'll do the next few problems of this worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.